Greetings and a warm welcome from Manu Patra to this video tutorial where I'm going to show you how to search in Manu Patra. What are the different tips and tricks that you can use to enhance your legal search and find the most relevant judgment in the quickest possible time. Let me begin with a quick introduction to my company. Manu Patra Information Solutions started its journey in the year 2001 as the pioneer of the online legal search space in India. Since then, we have grown into the largest content aggregator both for Indian and international database. From the day one of the company, our focus has been how to leverage technology to push the envelope for legal research in India. Our latest offering being MyCase, which is an end-to-end office management software. Coming back to this video tutorial, we will be covering how to sign in to Manu Patra, what is the content coverage of Manu Patra, what are the different search options available to you, how do you find judgments through keywords, sections, party name in Manu Patra? What are the ways you can save, email or print out a judgment? How can you use backward and forward linking in Manu Patra to find more cases that are suitable for your requirements? To sign into manupatra.com, just go to your browser, type in manupatra.com here. So now you have two ways to enter into the website. The first one being the username password based method. So you'll be given a username and a password through which you will be able to access. If you are accessing manupatra.com from your college IP address or your law firm has an IP access, then a button comes here, IP users login here. From there you will be able to sign into the website. Okay, now this is how the Manu Patra websites look from the inside. On the left hand side, we have the table of content. This is basically the catalog of Manu Patra. So everything that is there on the website, you can see from here. To search this catalog, we have different options available. Manu search, which is our text-based search, legal search. If you are looking for judgments on a particular section or a through party name, that way you can find it from here. We have a very comprehensive equivalent citations. More than 325 journals are covered. So if you are looking for a case by the citation of that particular case, you will be able to find that. Assisted search is the newest addition, which is the Boolean search made easy. So if you want to use Boolean search, but you don't intend to use formulas, inverted commas, anything like that, you can use assisted search. Let us start with showing you the content coverage of Manu Patra. So Manu Patra covers Supreme Court judgments as well as Supreme Court orders. All the 25 High Court judgments you will be able to see. Also the Privy Council judgments, Lahore, Peshawar, these old courts also we cover from 1850 onwards. Tribunals and commissions, all the major tribunals and commissions are covered, be it DRT, NCDRC, NCLT, NCLAT. So Manu Patra also covers a very comprehensive international database which comprises of Commonwealth English speaking countries plus US and UK. So Supreme Court decisions from these courts are also available on the website. There are English reports too from 2020 onwards, from 1873, maritime cases. So a very, very comprehensive international database as well. Coming to the next one, which is the business policy. So in the business policy folder, for any particular subject of law, we provide all the primary and secondary database in one folder. So suppose I am a corporate lawyer. So everything that I need to know about my subject is provided to me in one folder. All the acts, rules, regulations, due diligence, notification circulars. So everything is provided to me in one folder under business policy. Coming to the next one, which is the Bare Act folder, a very, very important folder for any legal practitioner. So central as well as state Bare Acts are available, both the rules and regulations as well as the Bare Acts are available. Just click on to this table of content and you can now choose if you want to go for it alphabetical wise, subject wise, chronological wise. Let me click on alphabetical wise. From here, A to Z, all the Bare Acts are available to you in one folder. Okay, so if I want to go for Companies Act, so this is the 2013 one and this is the 1956 one. To open this Bare Act, there are different functionalities that are available on the right hand side. So if you want to see this in a single document, click here and this will open in a single document. Now you can take out a printout of this from here or you can read whichever section you want to. Commentary option is also available simultaneously. Just click on to this one and you will also be able to access the secondary material. So we are providing both the primary and secondary at one place. Coming to the next icon, which is the annotations. So annotations or brief note on the sections are also available.
if you want to compare 2013 with the 1956 one, that you can do. Another one is rules and regulations related to this act. So if you want to read rules and regulations related to Companies Act 2013, that are available. If any bill is pending on this particular act, there will be this Parliament symbol that will be available. Similarly, if you want to read brief facts on the particular act, that also you will be able to do. So date of assent, statement of objective, any amendment that is pending on this, that all that information is available in this brief fact. Again, this is also a hyperlink. So once you click on to this one, Companies Act 2013, now it opens section wise. So section 1 is there, section 2 is there, and there is a bill pending on the section 2 of Companies Act 2013. Once you click here, it will tell you which is the amendment that is pending in the Parliament. If you want to read judgments on that particular section, you can just click onto this blue button. So section 5, click on section 5 blue button, and you will be able to get the judgments on the respective Companies Act. Coming to the next folder, which is the bills, drafts and ordinances. So pending bills, you will be able to track from here. There are different committee reports, court forms, court rules. All these data is also available to you. Similarly, forms are also there. So statutory forms on different subjects are available. Similarly, miscellaneous folder is there where you will be able to find extradition treaties, nation cases in news, budget. So all this information is also available. Coming to the next one, which is the ebooks and the academic ebooks. So these are different ebooks that are available to you. You can just click here and you will be able to download this also and read it in your spare time. Similarly, academic ebooks are also there. Articles are also present in Manupatra. So we have thousands of articles that get submitted to us by different professionals, students. So if you just type in the query here, say COVID-19, and make a search, and from here you will be able to see all the. Coming to the next one, which is the legal taxonomy. So legal taxonomy is just like a digest. So for a particular subject, you just select the subject from here and select the sub subject. At the end of it, you will get the relevant judgments based on the subject or the sub-subject that you have already. Before moving to the search part in Manupatra, let's do a quick recap. We have planned some quiz for you. So number one is, this particular icon on Manupatra denotes, number one, high court cases, bills pending in parliament, overruled cases, or the Bayer Act receives in the essay. Second question is, business and legal policy module in Manupatra gives you access to which of the following information? Option number A is judgment on a subject. Option number 2, only the central act and notifications. Option C, all the primary and secondary information on that subject. Option number D, reports and other secondary sources. So the correct answer is option number C. All the primary and secondary information on that subject is available in the business and policy folder for that subject. Let us do a quick recap of table of contents in Manupatra. So you can always select a particular code before making your search. That way your search is confined to that particular code. To open any folder in Bayer Act, you just have to click onto this plus sign and click on the hyperlink once it appears, and you will be able to open that table of content folder. Coming to the next segment of this training module, what are the different search options available in Manupatra? So there is Manu search, legal search, citation search and assisted search. Manu search is simply a text-based search which is powered by artificial intelligence and natural language processing. So if you are looking for any keyword related query, you can use Manu search. First query, which is appointment of arbitrator, and I'll make my search from here. So in whichever judgment appointment of an arbitrator is coming, it will take all those judgments. Initially, it will automatically take appointment of arbitrator as a phrase. I have not used any inverted commas or anything, but still it's taking it as a phrase. Now what you can do is you can search and result. Okay, so among these 19,000 judgments, you can search for some other query, say for an award, and you can refine it further. So now there are 2000 some results where appointment of arbitrator is also coming and foreign award is also coming. So there is this option for search and result. You get n number of times you will be able to refine your search. Okay, let me show you another smart way to search in Manu search,
just go to Manu search and type in your keywords. You don't need to write is, etc. No filler words, nothing. Just write your keywords that you're looking for. Say appointment, arbitrator, foreign award, and select this near each other option. What this near each other option does is it looks for these four words, appointment, arbitrator, foreign award, in a range of 20 words in any judgment. So in whichever judgment, appointment, arbitrator, foreign award is coming in a range of 20 words, it will automatically pick those judgments up. Okay, let's come to the filtration part. So you can always filter your results in terms of if you just want to read the Supreme Court judgments first, these are 21 such judgments. Based on the keywords also, you can further refine your search. On your judge's name, if you have a particular judge sahab in mind, you can use his name also. If you want to see the recent decisions 2010 and above, or you want to see like 2020, 5 decisions have already come on this topic that you can see. Document type, industry, if you're looking for a particular industry decisions that you can do, ministry wise, publisher wise, if you want to read higher judgment decision first, that is also possible. Another thing that you can do from here is, so this option is available, just the head note of the judgment. So if you click on to this one, this button Manu Instant, you will be able to read the act and the case note of the judgment. Okay, so subject is there, which were the acts that were used and what was the case note of the judgment. Okay, this is for Manu search. Let's come to the next one, which is the legal search. So legal search is when you are starting your search with a particular section in mind. Okay, so I want to look for judgments on NI 138. Okay, I can just write NI here, 138, search. Okay, so all these judgments, 14,000 some judgments where NI 138 was involved, you will be able to find these judgments. The search and result option is always available, so you can further refine your search results in terms of any query that you are looking for. Okay, let's go to the next one, which is the appellant respondent tab in the legal search option. So this is when you are looking for a party name based search. Use this appellant respondent tab. Say my case is Deep Trading Industries versus Indian Oil. So I can just write Deep here, Trading, and just write Indian Oil and make your search. Okay. So in whichever judgments, Deep Trading and Indian Oil is coming in the title of the judgment, it will take all those judgments. So for any party name search, this legal search and appellant respondent tab is very, very effective. One is the judge name search. So if you have a particular judge sahab in mind, so you can just write the name of the honorable judge here. Similarly, if you want to search in the head note or the case note of the judgment, there is a separate search for that. It's different. Any judgment that comes to Manupatra is categorized in different categories. You can search which are the most intellectual property right decisions that have been coming in. So that search is available. Similarly, you can do a date search on a particular date. If you're looking for a judgment, that you can do, you can also give a range. So if you're not very sure that it came somewhere in the last week, so you can just select a date from here and make your search. Okay. Similarly, citation search is also available. So a very comprehensive citation search, more than 330 journals we cover in Manupatra. From here, very easily, you don't even have to remember the format of the citation. Just if you're looking for, say, AIR Supreme Court judgment, you can just select AIR Supreme Court from here. You can put in the year number, say 1998, and there's no volume number in AIR, so you can put in the page number here, say 1. And so from here, very easily, you will be able to get to the judgment through citation. Even if you have a partial citation also, you will be easily able to get to the judgment. Okay, so this was the citation search. Coming to the next one, which is the act search in legal search. So just select act search from here. So here you can just write the bare act that you're looking for, CPC, Code of Civil Procedure. You can view the selected act. So this will open in a new window and you can take out a printout of this from here. And if you're looking for a particular word in Code of Civil Procedure, say if you're looking for the word review, so in whichever sections the word review is coming, that also you will be able to find very easily from here. Okay, coming to the last search option, which is the assisted search. So assisted search is a hybrid form of Manu search, which is Boolean search made easy. So if you are looking for a particular phrase, okay, say I am looking for child custody as a phrase, so I can just write child custody here
and it will take all those judgments where child custody is coming as a phrase, and I can write say visiting rights as a phrase again. So in whichever judgment child custody and visiting rights are coming individually as a phrase, it will take all those judgments again. We have already seen what near each other was. What we can also do from here is I can write say these four words, child custody and visiting rights, I want to give them a range, say 20 words or 50 words, say 20 words I'm choosing. So in whichever judgment these four words are coming in a proximity within 20 words, it will take all those judgments. Before moving forward, let's do a quick revision of what we have learned so far. So Manu Patra covers equivalent citations from 340 plus Indian law journals, but I have an incomplete citation for a case law. Can you search for a judgment in Manu Patra with partial citation? True or false? The correct answer is true. You are able to search with question number 4 of quiz. Near each other option function in Manu search gives me results where my keywords are coming in a range of 50 words, 20 words, 10 words or 5 words. The correct answer is results where my keywords are coming in a range of 20 words. Let us do a quick recap of the search options available in Manu Patra. Manu search is a natural language processing enabled text search in Manu Patra where you can search with your keywords. Legal search, if you are looking for a case law on a particular section, party name, date or subject, legal search is the search to go. If you are looking for a citation in Manu Patra, we have a very exhaustive citation search available for you. Number 4 is assisted search, which is Boolean search made easy. So if you want to use inverted commas, give a proximity search, so you can also use assisted search instead of Manu search in Manu Patra. Coming to our next section, which is what is the template of a judgment in Manu Patra. To open any judgment, there is this button that you can click here to open it in a new window. Another thing that I'd like to bring your attention to is this particular button. So any judgment which has this red flag in front of it, that means that case has been overruled. And once you click onto that, it will take you to the case where it has been overruled. Okay, so this is a very common question that we get. How do you know if a case is overruled or not? If there is a flag in front of that means that it has been overruled. And if you want to see where it has been overruled, click onto that one and it will take you to the case. Another thing that is there is sometimes there is an SLP pending on that case. This is a high court case. For that, we have this parliament sign available, which means that SLP is pending on this case. Once you open this judgment, there will be a button for SLP right here, and you will be able to get to the for this case. So this is the SLP pending in the Supreme Court for this particular case. Now let's open a judgment. So this particular icon, I'll click. And this is the template of a judgment in Manu Patra. On the right hand side, you can see that there is the Manu citation. Once you click on Manu citation, you will get the equivalent citations from AIR, ACC, DLT. All these citations are available with us. On the right hand side, there are different buttons. I will be coming to them. This is the judgment name. The Honorable Judge Sir, who has authored this judgment. Counsels that have appeared. Every judgment in Manu Patra is given a subject, so this has been given two subjects, trust in societies and right to information. These were the acts that were used in this particular judgment. And we also segregate relevant sections. So out of these sections, which actually the judgment was on Right to Information Act Section 2. So we segregate the important sections apart from the rest. These are the list of the cases that were referred in this judgment. Okay. And this is the prior history. So this case originally originated from the Kerala High Court disposition. And out of these cases that were cited in this case, which were the cases that were discussed, which were the cases that were mentioned. Similarly, if some case would have been relied on this case, that would also have been there. The industry is given, the head note is given for the judgment. And this is the body of the judgment. Okay, everything in Manu Patra is comprehensively hyperlinked. Just double click on section 2H and you will be able to read section 2H from here. And if you want to read more judgments on this, that you can do. Similarly, if any case is also mentioned, that will also be hyperlinked to the original case. Double click on any word and you will be able to get to the meaning of that word. So this dictionary is always available to you if you come across any Latin term, or for that you will be able to access from here. Okay, so this is the body of the judgment in Manupatra. You can use these navigation tools to move up and down. Okay, to download the PDF of the judgment, yeah, this is the button. So this is the Manupatra PDF. You can download it with or without case note from here. So this is how it looks. The Manupatra branding is there, equivalent citation is there, the name of the subscriber is there. Coming to the next one, if you want to send it as an email to a friend or a colleague, that you can do. The Word document is also available. If you want to leave sticky notes on this judgment, that you can do. You can mark these and take out a printout of that. You can leave notes on this. If you want to save it in your Dropbox or a Google Drive account, that is possible. If you want to save it in manupatra.com, so next time whenever you open manupatra.com, you will be able to find this in a separate folder, that you can do. Say I want to save it in insurance folder. Okay, now this is accessible to me whenever I am opening manupatra.com. This can be accessed from this particular folder, my saved documents. Now the display setting option is also available here. Just click on to this one and you will be able to read the same judgment in different format, or if you want to change the font size of the judgment, that you can do. If you want to change the spacing between the lines, if you want to change that you can do. And of course you can take out a printout of that from here. Another option that is available to take the printout is the print replica option. Now the print replica option is available right here. Here you will be able to find the print replica from different local journals. Okay, so this is Allahabad Weekly Cases. This is the scanned copy from Allahabad Weekly Cases of this case. So you can always take out a printout of this. Similarly, we have ILR Kerala. So different journals are available. If you want to take out the printout from the local journal and take it to the court, that option always is available here. Now the third option is of judis.nic. So judis English copy is available for all the judgments. So these are the Supreme Court or all the High Court upload their judgments court copy on a particular website, which is judis.nic. Not in, we provide this source document for all the Manupatra judgments also. So this will be available in all the judgments. So if you have any confusion in terms of the paragraph number, or you want to check for a certain spelling, all that is available here, and you can always download this as well from here. The Manu citation will always be there and the name of the subscriber will also come at the bottom. So once you give it to Honorable Judge Sal, he'll know that it is coming from you. Let us quickly revise what we have learned in this segment. So the next question is, I am reading a judgment and I come across a word in the text of the judgment, the meaning of which I don't know. What should I do? Should I look for my dictionary? Should I open Google and find meaning? Go to the home page of Manupatra and check it in dictionary? Or the fourth option, use the Manupatra feature, double click on that word and click on no more. I'm sure most of you have got it correct. The correct answer is option D. Use Manupatra feature, double click on that word and you will be able to find the meaning of that word. Quiz number 6. With the help of this feature, you can seamlessly jump from one referred document to another. Option number A is analytics. Option B is case map. Option C is hyperlinking. Option D is sessions list. So the correct answer for this one is number C, hyperlinking. So hyperlinking is a feature in Manupatra through which you can jump from one document to another. Now let us do a quick recap of the layout of the judgment section. So if you want to take out a printout of a particular judgment, you will find this button at the top of the judgment. If you want to send a mail to a colleague or a friend, you can directly send it from this icon. If you want to download the Word format of the judgment, that is available. If you want to create sticky notes on that particular judgment, you can highlight particular paragraphs that you are finding relevant, you can do that. If you want to save the judgment in manupatra.com or you want to save it in Dropbox, that is possible. Display settings are available if you want to change the formatting of the judgment, you want to change the font size or the spacing between the line, then display setting feature is available for you.
And print replica option is available if you want to check the source of the document. So this will always be available in the Supreme Court and all the court judgments.
Now coming to the final segment, which is how do you use Manupatra to find multiple cases if you just have one case. We will be using backward and forward linking in Manupatra to get to the relevant cases from one case. So on top of any judgment in Manupatra, you will find these icons which are extremely helpful. These uses artificial intelligence through which you will be able to find judgments which are more recent, which are more relevant to your case law. So this is one case law which has opened, which is Indian Oil Corporation versus Raja Transport, which is a 2009 decision by Supreme Court. Okay, now let's come to the first of these features, which is important para. Just click on to this one. An important para gives me the list of the paragraphs of the judgment which are quoted in future judgments. Okay, so this is one such paragraph, 21 number paragraph. This has been quoted two times in subsequent future Supreme Court decisions. Okay, so similarly, this is another such paragraph which has been quoted two times in a future judgment. Okay, so the idea is to give you the list of the paragraphs which are quoteworthy, which are basically the law points of the judgment that you can see in one list from here. Another thing is, if you found that this paragraph is important to you, this is exactly what you were looking for. Now you can have a more recent decision. This is a 2009 decision, this is a 2017 decision where you will be able to, which has quoted the same paragraph. Okay, now if I want to read this, I can click here and I'll be able to read this judgment as well. Another one is cited in para. Now cited in para gives me the answer to the question, is this case cited in some other case law or not? Okay, from here I'll be able to see the list of the judgments where my current case has been cited. Also, which paragraph of this judgment have used my case law, that also I'll be able to see from here. Okay, the next one is the case map. Once you click on case map, it will give you 20 relevant judgments related to this particular case law. So let us take this as a timeline. So this is a 2009 Indian Oil judgment. These are the judgments that came prior 2009 and were cited in this particular case. So the arrow is coming inward. So this has been discussed here. Another judgment, this one, has been mentioned here. So the legend is also given. So different, if it would have been affirmed somewhere, relied somewhere, that also you'll be able to see. Now what happened to Indian Oil after 2009? So after 2009, it got mentioned in this particular case. There were a couple of cases where it got discussed. And similarly, it got mentioned in some other case. Okay, just click on to this one. And you will be able to get to the now Northern Eastern Railway versus Triple Engineering 2014 becomes the center, and now you can follow where this was mentioned, where this was discussed, where this was affirmed. So all these treatments you are able to see from here. Another one is this one, which is authority timeline. So authority timeline gives me the list of the entire thing. So this gives me the all the 174 judgments. So from here you can see that this will gives me the entire 174 judgments where this has been cited, referred. Different citing references are also given. So if I want to see where this was relied on, I can see that. If I want to see where this was distinguished, I can see that. So all those treatments also you are able to see from here. Time for quiz. Quiz number 7. If I am reading a case and want to see the relevant paragraph in other cases where the current case has been cited, which of the following should I click? Important para, cited in para, judge analytics or case map? Now if I want to see where the current case law has been cited in future case laws, cited in para is the right answer. So option number B, cited in para. So the question number 8, case map gives you the visualization representation of dash cases where the current case law has been overruled, dissented, affirmed, relied on, distinguished or just mentioned in future cases. So the number of cases is 25, 20, 15 or 10. The correct answer for this one is 20. So case map gives you the visualization of 20 cases where your current case law has been overruled, dissented, affirmed, relied on or distinguished. Let us do a quick review of the features that we have covered in the last segment. Number one is cited in para, which gives you the list of all the judgments where the current case law has been cited. Case map gives you a visualization representation of 20 cases where your current case has been distinguished, followed or whatever treatment was given to that case in future cases, that you will be able to see from case map. Important para gives you the list of the most quoted paragraphs from the judgment, and also you can see where these paragraphs have been quoted, in which future judgment has these been quoted. You can also see from important para. So thank you for your time with us. If you have any queries, any suggestions regarding Manupatra, you can reach out to us at contact@manupatra.com. Thank you for your time.